What's going on, everybody? I'm VR Lad, and you are officially part of the VR Army. The Oculus Quest update 30 and 31 dropped very recently, and it completely eliminated the ability to live stream your gameplay directly to Facebook. And obviously, that left people very disappointed, including myself. But no need to fear, because VR Lad is here, and today I'm going to show you how you can live stream your Oculus Quest 2 gameplay to Facebook, Twitch, and YouTube. Bear in mind, guys, this will work on the Oculus Quest 2 update 30 and 31. But if you want to be in with a chance to win an Oculus Quest 2, click the card above to find out how you can do it. Also, guys, it's very, very important that you stay to the end, because I've got a section dedicated to help you get the most out of your streams and to making it look as good as possible, along with a few best practices. Let's go. Let's get straight into it. So what you'll need is an Oculus Quest 2, a PC or laptop with at least these specs. I wouldn't worry about them too much, they aren't too high. OBS Studio. Now, if you haven't used OBS Studio before, I'd recommend following some tutorials to find the best display settings for your system and make sure you're capturing at the best quality. And then you'll need Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge. So first up, what you'll need to do is install OBS Studio on your PC. Now make sure your Oculus Quest is connected to the same network as your PC. Go to your Quest on your home and press Sharing and then Cast. It will ask you how you want to cast your gameplay. Press Computer and it will give you a link that looks like this. Now go to Chrome or Microsoft Edge and navigate to that link. If it asks you to log into your Oculus account, do that. If not, it should then mirror exactly what's going on your Oculus Quest 2 headset in your browser. Next up, with the casting window still open, go to OBS and below Sources, click on the plus button and press Window Capture. You can name it if you want and press OK. Then click the window drop down and select Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge, whichever browser you're using. You should then see the gameplay of your Oculus Quest 2 inside of OBS. Now every time you open OBS, it will look for that window you have opened, and if the Quest is cast into your browser, it will always display it on OBS automatically, so you will only need to set this up once. Next, we need to make sure OBS captures the audio from the Oculus Quest. So click the plus button and click Audio Output Capture. Then on the device drop-down menu, select your regular PC audio output and click Apply. This could be your PC speakers, something like that. This means that any sound that your PC makes will be picked up in the stream. So just make sure when you're streaming that you disable audio you don't want to appear. Now, if you go to your casting window, you should see down the bottom right a few different icons. We are going to focus on the microphone icon and the audio icon. The audio icon will always need to be on, or you won't be able to hear any game sounds on your stream. The microphone icon, if turned on, will allow OBS to pick up your voice and allow you to speak to your viewers inside your live stream. So at the moment, guys, this is coming through the Oculus headset, running through audio output capture. You should be able to hear the game sounds. This means that both the game audio and the microphone audio will be captured on one audio track, so you would have to run a few tests and adjust the volume of the game to make sure you have a good balance between the two, or one will overpower the other and it just won't make for a good experience. However, now everything is set up, all you will need to do is go to your chosen streaming service. Now I'm going to use YouTube for the example, but this will work on Twitch and Facebook. Click Go Live on YouTube and it will display this window. Now this is where you would name your stream, add a thumbnail, and generally set your video up ready for the world to see. Now go to your stream key and press copy. Then navigate to your OBS, click settings and stream, and make sure you select the correct streaming service from the drop-down and then paste into the streaming box, replacing what was there before. Effectively, they should both match each other. Click Apply and the window will close. Now all you have to do is click Start Streaming and that's it. You are successfully live streaming your Oculus Quest through gameplay to Facebook, YouTube, or Twitch. But wait. So guys, at this point, your stream won't be perfect. So I'm gonna share you some useful tips and tricks, including getting your stream from looking like this to this. Along with some useful hints on how to get the most out of your streams. Let's get straight into it. So this may seem like a strange one, but first up is to stick blue tack on your Oculus headset sensor. So the reason for this, guys, is if you take the headset off, it will stop casting automatically and you'd have to restart the stream. If you stick blue tack to the sensor, it means it won't go into standby and it won't stop casting and your stream will continue as long as your battery does. Next up would be to resize the window and to make it look generally pretty. So what I mean by this, guys, you can resize and move the window so it fits better with what you're trying to achieve. You can also add additional images and text to make it stand out more and generally look better. Look at what I did with mine. So guys, that's pretty much it. If you follow this tutorial, you will be able to live stream your Oculus Quest 2 footage to Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch. This would include any game like Beat Saber, Population 1, literally any of the game labs. Now, has this been helpful? Let me know down in the comment section. Make sure you subscribe and join the VR Army because I want you. Thanks for watching. I'm VR Lad, and I'll see you soon. Peace.